Hi, I'm State Senator Kevin Parker. I represent the 21st District in Brooklyn, which is Flatbush and East Flatbush, Midwood, Ditmas Park, Kensington, Windsor Terrace, and Park Slope. And welcome to a report from the State Senate. As you know, one of the big interests I have, particularly because Brooklyn College is one of the largest institutions in the 21st District, is higher education. I'm a product of higher education myself, having gone to the New School and been a student at the CUNY Grad Center. Today, I'm really excited not just to have somebody who is an expert in higher education and education in general, but somebody who's been a mentor and a friend and somebody who really has done so much. A former state senator, somebody who's ambassador to the UN, vice president at Citibank, former state controller of the state of New York, and now the chairman of the State University of New York, H. Carl McCall.
Senator Parker, it's so good to be with you. You say all that, people think, well, you know, I'm a guy that couldn't keep a job.
You know? That's not true.
But I've just, as you have, you know, New York is such a great place for opportunity. It's mm-hmm. a place where someone like you and me, because we got a good education, can move ahead and get elected to the Senate and do so many other important things. So you and I have this passion that we share for education.
Absolutely. And I wanted to, I guess, I'll publicly thank you because much of the things I've been able to do is because of the time I spent working for you in the State Control's office.
You weren't working for me. People weren't clear about who was, you know, who was working for whom. It was a great experience we had together, and I'm so glad that I participated in your career development.
Thank you.
And
we're
all so proud of you and what you've accomplished.
Well, we're very proud of you. So I just want to really hear a lot about the State University of New York. I have a lot of, you know, my district is in the heart of Brooklyn.
Of course.
There's a ton of constituents and their children who attend the State University. Can you talk a little bit just about the system
represents a great opportunity for people to have an affordable quality education. We are, New York State has the largest public higher education system in the country.
Right.
We have 64 colleges, universities, community colleges, technical schools, medical schools, law schools, you know, and the thing about it, it's affordable. With your help and the help of other legislators, we now have what we call a rational tuition program that's kept tuition at a moderate level. It's costs now about $6,000 a year to go to a SUNY four-year school, about $3,800 to go to one of our community colleges. That is a bargain, but what you get is a very good quality education. I mean, we're really clear about the fact that, you know, this isn't, it's a bargain in terms of cost, but in terms of quality, it's at the top of the line. And there's something for everybody. There are the community colleges, there are the four-year colleges, and the location is important because we have four schools in New York City, but we have other schools all across the state. And for a lot of kids in your neighborhood, in my old neighborhood, it was good sometime to get out of the
right.
of the hood,
absolutely.
You know, to
absolutely.
Go to some other place. I mean, it really was transformational for me to be able to leave my community and go to a real campus and be part of that campus experience.
Right.
So that's what we offer. And I just urge people to contact your office or contact us at SUNY if they want more information. We have 460,000 students in our schools throughout the state. And it's just great now, this is commencement season, to go around and see kids graduating and, you know, going on to careers. We have a commitment to quality education and to success. We want kids not only to come to school, we want to be accessible, but we also want to make sure kids complete their education. So we really work with them and have programs to make sure they graduate. And then we're concerned about their success when they leave. We're concerned about their careers and what they do, and we try to prepare them for the very complicated world in which we want them to go out and provide leadership.
Has the governor talked to you about his new proposal to create these tax-free zones around the SUNY campuses?
We had a big conference with that on yesterday. One of the things that the governor, by the way, has been very supportive of SUNY. And the reason is we have offered him something. The governor recognizes the need to have economic development programs where we really provide training for people and have relationships, private, public partnerships, relationship with businesses to create jobs and economic opportunities. Well, SUNY provides a platform for that because we've got schools all over the state. We've got people on our campuses who do research, who do outreach. And this new plan, which the governor's called, tax-free SUNY,
right.
If a company wants to have a relationship with one of our colleges, they can come and have that relationship. the college can use that business that has the relationship for internships, for kids to work and have some work experience, and also to do research. And the companies that come and develop a relationship with a SUNY campus, they will pay no state corporate taxes, and the employees of the company don't pay any personal state income taxes. So it's trying to do away with this image that New York is a high tax place, a state that only concerned about, you know, raising taxes and getting taxes from people. But we're saying, look, don't pay any taxes. Come be part of a program on a SUNY campus and really make a contribution to the economy of that community.
And it actually really has an impact on the population, because when we look at a lot of the population actually decline that we've seen in the state of New York, particularly upstate, the only place that we're actually getting people in is actually around these campuses. And so now, if you have a relationship with the university, then that means those students have an opportunity now to be employed there, and thus, you know, help increase and actually hold on to some of the population.
And to stay in New York.
Yes.
You know, I think it's really important, and, you know, I represented a Senate, when I was in the Senate, my Senate district was Harlem and the West Side, you represent Brooklyn, but yet we have a concern about the rest of the state.
That's right.
If we see people leaving upstate and the overall population declining, that's bad for Brooklyn,
that's
bad for Harlem.
That's right.
We need to think about the entire state and how we make all parts of the state viable.
So what is the next kind of big things for SUNY as a system?
The next big thing for SUNY as a system is to really become preeminent in the whole field of online education, distance education. The big problem in education is the cost of buildings and capital, you know, and maintaining infrastructure. The fact is, with technology today, we really have opportunities to do education and really train people and educate them online. Now, to take courses online and therefore not have to go to a particular campus. You might have some campus experience, but you might have a combination of campus experience and online experience. And this is happening all over the country now. People are coming up with innovative ways to educate people at a distance rather than having them all. And therefore, you can get some of the best professors, some of the best teachers who can reach even a larger audience. You know, somebody can stand up in an auditorium and talk to a couple of hundred students, but if you can go online and talk to a couple of thousand students, then you're getting more bang for your buck.
Right.
It's a more efficient way. But you have to also make sure that when you do this, you maintain the quality, and you also have accountability, and you have an opportunity for students to have an interactive experience. You know, you don't want to just sit and have somebody lecture. You want to be able to respond. So we really think that as the largest public higher education institution, we ought to be a leader in the whole issue of online education. And Chancellor Zimfa, who's been so creative and helpful in moving in a lot of new directions, this is now her commitment that she's brought to the board, which we've endorsed. And we are moving to really become preeminent in the whole field of online distance education.
Yeah, I think that's excellent, and that's certainly going to be really important as the ranking member on energy and telecommunications. And as the, I'm actually also a member of the New York State Commission on Science and Technology for the state.
Okay.
This is absolutely the direction that actually almost every other university is going into. So we
everybody's doing it, and they have some interesting opportunities here. And you're right, and this is where you see the technology applied in a way that it really can make a difference.
Right.
So we will be coming to you and legislators to talk in some depth about our plans, and we'll want your support for SUNY becoming much more involved.
Absolutely.
And just think about what that'll mean for your constituents to be able to take courses online. To, you know, this means a person can work during the day and take a course at night or take a course on a weekend. It just provides the kind of flexibility that will give us an opportunity to reach a broader range of students and for students to have greater opportunities.
Right, absolutely. So I wanted to, as we start wrapping up, I wanted to talk a little bit about the issue of Downstate Medical Center and you know, Brooklyn University Hospital. We're in the process, you know, we've had you're the one who told us there's a crisis there. You've been, I have to thank you because you really came to us, not just with the kind of, you know, sounding the alarm, but also with a plan and a solution. We started working through that. We have a new leadership there in Dr. Williams. Mm-hmm. And we're doing some creative mm-hmm. things. Can you talk a little bit about...
Sure. I want to thank you for your support of what we've been trying to do to save. Brooklyn, a downstate medical center is so critical. Mm-hmm. You've heard the statistics. One out of three doctors now serving in Brooklyn graduated from downstate. One out of nine doctors in New York City graduated from downstate. Nurses, other healthcare providers. Downstate has been just tremendous in providing the kind of medical professionals we need. And also, we're at the very top in this country in terms of providing those experiences for minority medical mm-hmm. students and minority medical professionals. But, you know, healthcare has been very difficult. Reimbursement rates for Medicaid and Medicare, people who don't have any insurance at the present time, that has represented a real strain on downstate. And we've been losing money. And as a result of that, we've had to restructure, we've had to lay people off, we've had to make the institution more efficient, and we will continue to do that. But we've come up with a new plan that recognizes that you can't solve the problem of downstate and our medical school on its own. That all of Brooklyn has a need for a better medical network. And this is what we are now recommending, that we set up a public benefit corporation, which will enable us to bring about more coordination and collaboration and sharing of services among all of the hospitals or a number of hospitals in Brooklyn. And by working cooperatively, we're able to do things, for instance, by procurement. If we've got to buy supplies and goods for our hospitals, if we do that as a collective, as a number of hospitals going together to suppliers, we can get better prices and therefore bring down our costs. But more important, we can improve the quality of our care by deciding what hospitals will provide what kind of services. So every hospital doesn't have to do everything, but some hospitals can specialize in certain medical practices and medical services. Other hospitals can do other services that aren't being provided. So we want to have a network of hospitals working together to provide real top quality medical services to people throughout Brooklyn, and downstate will be the leader, really, in that effort.
And so the first piece, actually, I guess, is a legislative piece where mm-hmm. we would actually have to create
this new public benefit corporation. That is going to come to the legislature. We hope you will support it, and you'll get your colleagues from across the state. Just as you're concerned about issues affecting the rest of the state, you've got to get people, the rest of the state, to say, we're going to step up and help you do what needs to be done in Brooklyn to provide good medical care, and to make sure that Downstate Medical Center and University Hospital continues to provide to meet the critical medical needs of your community.
Yeah, and I think the critical part of that, I think, is important for my viewers to hear from you, is both there's a mm-hmm. commitment and a funded commitment from both the perspective of the medical school, mm-hmm. but as well as of University Hospital, because even though it's specifically there to help the needs of the medical school, people in that community have really come to depend on the high quality of care that Downstate is known for.
And they're able to get that care because, you know, we have the residents, we have the students, getting their experience, but at the same time providing services to people in the community. So it's a great collaboration. It's been going on for a long time, and I'm committed to it, and we really want to thank you for your support.
No, thank you very much. I was going to say controller, but chairman.
Whatever, you know.
Chairman McCall, I wanted to thank you very much for spending this time with us and talking about the direction of SUNY. I think the online program that's coming with SUNY is very, very exciting. And obviously, we're going to continue to work very closely together on issues as relates to Downstate Medical Center and University Hospital in Brooklyn.
Thank you.
Thank you. And for anything that you may need in terms of public education, feel free to reach out to my office. I'm at 718-629-6401. And until the next time, I'm State Senator Kevin Parker, and this is a report from the New York State Senate.